Hello everyone, I'm Epcot Ethan, and this is the Beginner's Guide to Magic Kingdom. You will have history, basic layout, clips, tips, and tricks. When you park at the Magic Kingdom, you're not actually parking at the Magic Kingdom, believe it or not. You're parking at the Transportation and Ticket Center. You have to ride a monorail, or a ferry boat, to the actual Magic Kingdom park. We are going to do the monorail. Here we are at the Magic Kingdom entrance after traveling on the monorail from the Transportation and Ticket Center. Walt Disney World is currently celebrating its 50th anniversary. Now we're gonna go under the train station and enter into the Magic Kingdom. Here is the first land, Main Street, USA. Magic Kingdom has Six Lands, Main Street USA, Adventureland, Frontierland, Liberty Square, Fantasyland, and Tomorrowland. Main Street USA is seen to the turn of the century, America, supposedly after Walt Disney's small hometown, Marceline, Missouri. There's various restaurants, shops here. And here is the castle. So beautiful. The largest shop in the Magic Kingdom is the Emporium. All of this is actually the Emporium, but the outside it looks like different shops. It's not, don't be fooled. And here is the beautiful castle being hid by this tree. We are here for early morning hours. It's because we stayed at a Disney Resort Hotel, not really the one in Disney Springs. There weren't any Disney hotels for us to book. They haven't been for months upon months. But I think it's supposed to be quite crowded this week. We've not really seen that yet, but maybe today we will. So now we're gonna pass through Tomorrowland by Cosmic Rays to go towards Fantasyland.
Don't you feel that magic?
Yeah, there's an entire word going to Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. You have to encounter this mess when you're on your trip. Seven Dwarfs Mine Train is a must-do. It's not too extreme, so pretty much anyone who meets a height requirement can ride it. We just did it twice, but one was the DAS, so you probably wouldn't be able to do that on a regular morning. Yeah, there used to be another attraction, Snow White's Adventures. That is gone. If you've been in years previous and you're expecting that, it's not here anymore. Now they have this attraction. I got a Cheshire Cat Town. Now this is my favorite snack in the Magic Kingdom. I love it. It's my favorite snack, I think, in the entirety of the whole Walt Disney World Resort. It's so good. Definitely get the Cheshire Cattail when you get a Magic Kingdom. Either just a snack or some breakfast. They also do serve hot tea there, which I do like. I didn't get any of those, just a bit too warm for that today. Look how pretty the castle is. The castle is so beautiful. Yeah, as I have previously mentioned, Magic Kingdom is celebrating its 50th anniversary. It opened in 1971. It's very beautiful. Here is Adventureland. So, in Adventureland, one of the oldest attractions, pretty much the main attraction, is the Jungle Cruise. This time of year, there is a seasonal overlay called the Jingle Cruise. Thank you. I really like the Jungle Cruise, but I also really like the normal Jungle Cruise. I do actually quite like Phineas and Wings. Our skipper, Katarina, was very, very funny. But yeah, it does kind of sometimes depend on what skipper you have. They're usually quite funny, so. The other ride in Adventureland is Pirates of the Caribbean. Pirates of the Caribbean is a classic and a must-do for your family. It does have a drop, but it's not a big drop at all. I don't like roller coasters, so you can take it from me. Your child might be a bit scared, but it's fine. I think it's good for all ages. Over here is Splash Mountain. Now, I don't like that ride, mostly because I just don't like the drop. That's like the only reason, so we aren't riding yet, but it is going to be rethemed soon. Big Thunder Mountain is also really great. It's still not too extreme of a roller coaster. It's a bit jerky, so if you have issues, I guess, with jerky rides, then maybe you shouldn't ride. But I really like it. It's one of my favorites. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion.
Truly stretching, or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge to find a way out. There's always my way. Frighten you prematurely. The real chills come later.
And there be music from regions beyond.
Haunted Mansion, another must-do classic. It is a tad bit scary, maybe. Like, the beginning and the stretching room might be a bit scary for small children. The rest of the ride is almost like they're happy ghosts. They're not angry ghosts, I guess. It's really not that scary. Maybe a little child might be a tad bit scared. Most likely, they'll be okay with it. They might be a bit scared walking in. We are now in Magic Kingdom's flagship land, Fantasyland. There's nothing on the PhilharMagic sign, which is a bit strange.
If you ask me, we'll never reach that dream.
Bobby! Bobby Rainy!
Oh dear! Hang on tightly, Roo!
Look, Mama, look! I'm on fire!
Come back with me!
My favorite.
Don't think this is just great, doesn't it? Follow me! Phew, I almost bounced right out of the ride!
One gathered together to say, Hooray! Hooray for Pooh, too!
Winnie the Pooh is another great ride. I still really like it. It's not as, if you miss it, it's not the biggest deal in the world. But if you have little kids, it's a definite must do. I still really like it though. So if you're older and an adult or just going by yourself, then you still should ride it. But if you have little kids, it's a definite must do. Now we are in Tomorrowland for lunch at Cosmic Rays Starlight Cafe. Cosmic Rays is pretty good. I don't think it's my favorite in all Magic Kingdom. I would have to say that would be Columbia Harbor House. Still quite good. I really like the trend of mac and cheeseburgers they're doing.
And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Carousel of Progress is another great attraction. I really like it. It's the only attraction in Walt Disney World that Walt Disney actually touched. It goes through the decades of the 20th century, through the innovations that occurred. It's also really good because you can sit inside for about 20 minutes in air conditioning. So that is quite nice. Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin is pretty much a low-tech Toy Story Mania, so it's themed around Buzz Lightyear. It's okay, honestly. If you miss it, that's okay. It really needs to be updated, honestly. It's a bit outdated by this point, and the buttons don't work very well. That new coconut Dole Whip is so good. That is my favorite Dole Whip. It does actually have real milk. The other Dole Whips actually are not made from milk. They're made from coconut milk. So if you're unable to eat dairy for some reason, you couldn't have it, but I'm okay with it. So I really liked it. It was great. It's really good with that Pog juice, which is the passion fruit orange and guava juice, which is what they serve at Disney a lot at breakfast and other things. So that's a definite thing to get. But I believe it is going away after the 50th celebration, which ends, I think, at the end of 2022. So you still have some time. We're back in Fantasyland for It's a Small World. They have recently repainted the interior. It's a Small World is definitely another must-do. It's very good for little kids, but for the big kids as well. You just need to go and ride it once.
Over here is the Be Our Guest restaurant.
Journey of the Little Mermaid is another great fantasy and dark ride. It's a bit newer than the other ones. Little Mermaid is one of my favorite Disney movies. So, yeah, I quite like it. Now that we've rode Buzz Lightyear again, we're going to go on to the Crystal Palace for dinner.
One of the shops in Main Street is the confectionery, which has been recently remodeled. That is so cool. Here is the Crystal Palace.
Crystal Palace was very good. I did enjoy my food there. Some things I didn't like, but the mushrooms weren't that good. And what was it? I didn't like the cheese, and I like stronger cheeses, but it had like no taste, which was kind of strange. I liked almost everything there. The chicken was definitely the best thing. So if you go there, definitely get that country fried chicken.
Today I'm facing my fears. Today, I'm going on to Space Mountain.
I rode this attraction once when I was 7 years old. I didn't like it, we'll say that. I was a bit terrified, a bit of tears involved. But now I'm gonna face my fears and overcome them.
Okay, here I am.
Space Mountain wasn't really that bad at all. I actually quite liked it, and we're gonna ride it again later. So, I saw several young kids ride it. If you think your kids will be comfortable, that's okay. If you don't think they will be, but I liked it. But I wouldn't ride it previously, so I'll just tell you that.
Look how they have it all lit up.
Walt Disney's dream for an experimental prototype community of tomorrow. Progress City was the inspiration for Epcot, and many of its forward-thinking ideas have been realized throughout Walt Disney World.
I know, look how far they've gone since the last time we were here. Here we are at the Mad Tea Party. House of Wonderland is another one of my favorite Disney movies. This is probably my most watched one. I watch it all the time. That one and Robin Hood, I literally watch about every weekend at my house. Things are quite difficult to spin. I am getting sort of dizzy, but not too dizzy. Now, they do say that a lot of people do get dizzy on this one, so if you get dizzy easy, probably do not ride this. But if you don't,
Write this. And you do not have to spin it. I just choose to make it a bit more fun.
Now over here is the Tomorrowland Speedway. I'm not a big fan of it. The cars are super old, super loud. They smell terrible. So unless you have kids who really want to drive, which I do not look forward to driving. Coming up is our Storybook Circus. It's sort of mini lane within Fantasyland. There's Dumbo the Flying Elephant. We didn't do it today, but it's definitely a must do. The classic and the Barnstormer, which is pretty much every toddler ever's first roller coaster. If you're a bit older, not that great. Still do it though.
I want to mention some tips and tricks real quick. Well, so mention facts first. Magic Kingdom is actually built on two levels. Well, you are always on the second level. On the first level, there's something called the Utilidors. Cast members travel under it. So always know that there are people under you. Two also reminders, we do have the DAS, Disability After Service, and we are annual pass holders. If you do not qualify for either of those or are not one of those, we may be able to do more things because of that, that you can't do. Up here is the Beast Castle. It's actually quite small, believe it or not. Inside is over here is Prince Charming's Regal Carousel. It is an old carousel from the year 1917. So yes, I think you should do it. We didn't do it, but it is just a carousel. By this point, the day is almost pretty much over, but everyone is leaving with a smile, and that's just what I love about Disney. Of course, always going to be people unhappy, toddlers throwing temper tantrums, but generally, you are very happy here, and it's my favorite place on the planet, most likely. I'm not quite sure about that, but probably we go on vacation here once, twice a year. We really love here, and I really love here. Went the first time when I was 4. We go there once or twice a year ever since then. Over here is Columbia Harbor House. We didn't eat there today. It's a great quick service restaurant though. I think it's my favorite quick service in the Magic Kingdom, so eat here when you go. Up here is the Liberty Tree Tavern. We are eating here later in the trip, but because this is a beginner's guide, I wanted to go ahead and mention it. Now over here is the Diamond Horseshoe. You've never eaten here. Over here is the Pecos Bill's Tall Tale Inn and Cafe. Another good quick service restaurant. The fireworks are going on. Well, the fireworks are now already in Big Thunder Mountain. Yes. Now for the last ride of the day, Big Thunder Mountain. Our last ride was Big Thunder Mountain. We got to watch it with the fireworks. That was just so, that was magical. That's like what you go to Disney for. It was absolutely incredible. Just really magical experience. But yeah, we also rode 20 rides today. That is unheard of. That has never happened in the history of the world. That just doesn't happen. It just doesn't happen. You don't ride 20 rides one day at a Disney park. Not 20 separate rides, but like we rode a ride 20 times. But that is just, that's incredible. So this new Genie Plus system really does work. Here is the Country Bear Jamboree. Over here is the Tiki Room, which we really like, but we didn't get to do today. Over here is the Skipper Canteen Restaurant, which is table service. Crystal Palace is so beautiful. It's very Victorian in its architecture. Crystal Palace was a real building in England, but it got destroyed in a fire in 1936. Here is where they keep the Omnibus. Very beautiful. It's where they keep it backstage. Because yeah, there's so many people that have heard us out a different way. So here we are backstage. Oh, these are the main street vehicles. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. Thank you and goodbye.